Hello friends, in this video we are going to find out the radar range equation for a continuous wave radar, and we are also going to understand the concept of continuous wave radar. At the same time, we'll also have a look of block diagram of continuous wave radar and its working. The radar is basically used for detecting and tracking the location of the object. There are two types of radar that can be used. The first one is the continuous wave radar and second is the pulse radar. The continuous wave radar is basically used the Doppler frequency shift for identifying or tracking or for detecting the moving object. So in this topic, we are going to discuss the following points, and the points are working principle of continuous wave radar. Then we will have a discussion on Doppler shift creation through reflection from target. Then we will also discuss the block diagram of simple continuous wave radar. Then we will have a frequency resolution and dwell time discussion. Then we will derive the equation for radar for continuous wave operation. And then we'll end the topic with the help of MCQs. So let's discuss first the operating principle of continuous wave radar. The continuous wave radar uses the Doppler frequency shift for detecting the moving target. In continuous wave radar, the signal is transmitted continuously by using the same antenna. The name continuous wave indicates the radar uses unmodulated carrier signal, which is transmitted and received directly by the antenna. So in case of continuous wave radar, as the transmission and reception takes place simultaneously. In case of continuous wave radar, it is very much important to use the separate antennas, as the transmission and reception takes place simultaneously. As it is a direct transmission and reception, therefore the continuous wave radar provides a fixed and short range. To enable the continuous or simultaneous transmission and reception, the separate antennas are required to be used. And this technique is achieved by using a spiral separation. The other method can also be used, and that is called as frequency separation. Now let's look at the diagram of continuous wave radar. So basically, if the target is not moving, then the reflected signal obtained from the target having a weak amplitude, and therefore the Doppler shift is also weak. This Doppler shift is not able to identify the location of the target. Now in case of continuous wave radar, the transmitter generates oscillations at the frequency ft, and that is transmitted directly by using the antenna. The reflected signal from the receiver determines whether the object is moving towards the radar or whether it is moving away from the radar. If the received signal having a positive sign, then it indicates that, or we can say if the Doppler shift is positive, that means plus FT, then it indicates that the target is moving close to the radar system. And if the Doppler shift, that is FT, having minus sign, then it indicates that the target is moving away from the radar. The radar, in case of continuous wave radar, the transmitter generates unmodulated carrier wave, and it is transmitted by using an antenna. In this case, the antenna is used as a transmitting antenna because we are using a frequency separation method. Now moving towards the block diagram of continuous wave radar, the block diagram shows a simple continuous wave radar which operates on the principle of frequency separation. Now here, the single antenna is used for transmission as well as reception purpose by using a frequency separation method. So the transmitter generates oscillation at the frequency FT, which is called as Doppler frequency, and it is directly transmitted towards the target. The received echo signal having a frequency, that is FT plus minus FD. Now here, the receiver must have an ability to differentiate between the frequencies of the echo signal and frequency of the transmitted signal. Now from the block diagram, we will also come to know that after receiving the signal, that is echo signal having frequency of FT plus minus FD, then the signal is get multiplied, or the transmitter leakage is get added to the received echo signal, and it is get mixed by using a detector mixture. The function of detector mixture is to just add the transmitter leakage with the echo signal. Now the Doppler filter is basically used here to allow only the Doppler frequency shift to the pass. It removes all the high noise component or all the high frequency other than the Doppler frequency. Now let's derive the equation for radar range for a continuous wave radar. Now before going to the radar range equation, first let's define the frequency resolution, and it is given by a formula. Delta F, that is frequency resolution, is equals to 1 upon TD, where TD stands for dwell time. Now, the dwell time is nothing but the time taken by the signal to transfer or to travel from transmitter to target, that is in the forward direction, and again get reflected back from target to the receiver, that is reverse direction. So that time is nothing but same as the dwell time. From the equation, we come to know that as there is an inverse relationship between the frequency resolution and dwell time, therefore smaller the value of dwell time increases the frequency resolution. Similarly, higher the value of dwell time decreases the frequency resolution because they have an inverse relationship between them. Now, the size of narrow band filter is given by N is equals to 2fmr divided by delta f, where delta f is the maximum frequency, where fmr is the maximum frequency. So the dwell time can also be defined as TD is equals to N upon 2b, where b stands for bandwidth. So for high PRF, the range equation can be given as so the value is SNR is equals to P average TI G square lambda square psi divided by 4 pi cube R raised to 4 K TEF into L. Now here P average is nothing but the average power transmitted by antenna over a dwell time. TI is the target time. G is the antenna gain. R is the range of antenna. K is the Boltzmann constant. TE is the effective temperature. F is a noise figure. And L is the losses in the antenna. So when we replace TI from TD and P average is equals to P sub CW, then we'll get the value of range for continuous wave radar. So let's write down the same equation. So now here we obtain the equation, that is radar range equation for continuous wave radar, simply by replacing the P average with PCW, that is average power transmitted by continuous wave radar over dwell time, and by replacing TI with TD, that is target time is get replaced by TD. So when we increase the value of target time, then it will increases the value of signal to noise ratio. So simply by replacing the P average by PCW and P and TI with TD, we can get the range equation for continuous wave radar. So this is how we can derive the range equation for continuous wave radar, which uses a concept of Doppler frequency shift for targeting or for detecting the moving target. If the moving target having positive Doppler frequency shift, then it indicates that the target is moving towards the radar. And if it is having negative frequency shift, then it indicates that the target is moving away from the radar. But in case of continuous wave radar, from the block diagram, if we again move back to the block diagram, so here when the frequency of echo signal is get added or is get multiplied with the transmitter leakage, then the Doppler filter removes the sign of the signal. So that is one considered as one of the disadvantage of the continuous wave radar, that is the sign is get removed from the signal. So now let's move to the MCQ part. So the first question is, the use of continuous wave radar is to, the options, let's consider this as option A, that is to measure the Doppler shift. Option B is to measure the range resolution of the target. Option C, measure the unambiguous true range of the target. And option D is remove stationary clutter signal. So we can say the use of continuous wave radar is basically to measure the range resolution of the target. So let's move to the next question. The dwell time is closely approximated with, and the options are reciprocal of PRF, target elimination time, RCS of the target, all of this. So we can say the option is nothing but target elimination time is same as the dwell time, as it nothing but the time taken by the signal to travel in the forward direction as well as in backward direction. That is from transmitter to the target and again moving back from target to the receiver. So this is what about the continuous wave radar, which is used in the application like radar tracking, which is used in the application like military applications. So this is what about the continuous wave radar and the range equation of the continuous wave radar. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.